This tutorial will look at the response tool in Google Forms and the options that are available. In Google Forms, by default, the data that your form collects is stored in two different locations. The first location is the form itself, and this data is designed to be view only and cannot be manipulated by Google Drive. The second location is the responses spreadsheet that is attached to the form, and that data can be manipulated and changed as you see fit. We'll talk more about this as we go through the tutorial. Here we are in a Google form, and from the menu bar I'm going to click on responses. The first option determines whether or not your form is on and accepting responses, or off and not accepting responses. The menu option always shows the current setting. In this case, my form is on. Clicking it turns my form off and allows me to type in a custom message to my audience explaining why the form is no longer accessible. Clicking responses again will allow me to turn the form back on. Summary of responses allows you to access the data stored in the form itself. If you're asking questions that have quantifiable answers, Google Forms will display that in a graph view. Notice, however, that I cannot modify this data. I cannot manipulate it. I can, however, click this View All Responses link, which is a shortcut to the responses spreadsheet, which also contains a copy of my form data that I can select and modify as I see fit. Going back to my Google form and responses, View Responses is another shortcut to the responses spreadsheet that has the data that, again, we can manipulate and edit as we see fit. Change response destination is where you can configure how you want your Google form to interact with the responses spreadsheet. By default, your Google form will create a new spreadsheet based on the title of your form and add responses to the end of the name. You have the option to have your Google form send the response data to a new sheet in an existing spreadsheet. Please refer to the link in the video descriptor below for more information about a new spreadsheet versus a new sheet in an existing spreadsheet. If you don't want to use a separate responses spreadsheet to collect your data, you can use this option to unlink your form with the spreadsheet. This means your Google form will continue to collect response data, but it will only be stored in the form itself. Now, at the beginning I said that the data stored in the form you cannot manipulate or edit in Google Drive. However, there is a way to get access to that form data so that you can manipulate it. To do that, come to the File menu, Download As, and choose Comma Separated Values. This allows you to download the Google Form data in the form itself as a CSV file, which you can then use another program like Numbers or Microsoft Excel and edit the data. Coming back to Forms, clicking on Responses. If you choose to delete all responses, this deletes all the response data within the Google form itself. This does not affect any data that is being collected in a responses spreadsheet. because the Google Form data and the Google Spreadsheet data are independent of each other. So to review, click the Responses menu option in Google Forms to decide how you want to interact with your response data and how you want your form to handle that information by deciding whether or not your form is on or off, viewing a summary of your responses collected by the Google Form itself, accessing the spreadsheet that is also collecting your Google Form data, changing where the Google Form data is being sent to, unlinking a Google Form spreadsheet responses, and just use your Google Form itself to collect the data, and delete all the response data from the form's memory, not the responses spreadsheet. This concludes this tutorial.